Hey, Survivor Geeks, please like, share, and subscribe. Check out my Survivor puzzle app and my merchandise store. The links are below in the description.
All right, let's start with the obvious. Big part of the advantage is you get to come second and see what the other five did. You see James on the jury. Jesse, surprised, or is it impossible to know what was going on?
I'm a little bit shocked. James seemed to have a lot going for him in the game, and I know he had an advantage. Knowledge is power, and there were some advantages at play in the last tribal, so I thought he might be able to like make a move and didn't expect to see him over there.
Ryan, are you surprised by this result?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting him over there.
What's gonna happen when you go back to camp?
For me, I'm gonna wanna talk to everybody that was at the last tribal, the tribal before us. I really wanna see where everybody lies, what really happened, so I can understand who's making moves, who's shaking things up, because there were some alliances that James was a part of that is now really shattered a little bit without him there.
All right, so let's get into this five. You had a different afternoon. Cassidy, what was the vibe like?
For me, it was glorious. I've been dreaming about peanut butter and jelly for like 12 or 13 days. But, you know, the game doesn't stop for anybody. So you realize, bam, I'm right back in the belly of the beast, you know? And then here we are back in a small tribe dynamic. And the monster tonight is also hungry. It wants two heads for the price of one. It wants everybody front and center so it can pick and choose who it wants to devour tonight, you know, all except for Cody, who's protected by the golden monkey, but.
The golden monkey, I like it. So Ryan, Cassidy said it really well. The fact that there's only five people means there has to be some level of concern for everyone.
I would have to definitely agree with that, Jeff. And now when we hear our name on that vote, it has a lot more ring to it. It's a lot more dangerous because three Ryans can mean I'm out. So it's a lot scarier. I'm not ready for you to come down here and say, okay, I'm gonna read the votes.
Cassidy, what's that like when you see somebody that you just talked to and then they walk down the beach with somebody else? What are you thinking? What are the fears?
At this point, you're kind of starting to get used to it and knowing that it's an inevitable evil, but it is a little nerve-wracking because they could be talking to you and then going and laughing about you to another person and be like, aha, they believe me about this. So you just never know what kind of conversations people are having. It's like, you almost wish you had a can that you could like somehow, I don't know, string over there and listen to their conversation. I don't know, maybe you could get crafty, but it is tough. It's nerve-wracking, always.
So Cody, you're in that great spot where you have no concern tonight, but you still have a long-term plan, so you still want to influence the vote. What's the perspective, given this is the first time you've had the necklace?
Oh yeah, the reality of it is I'm the man of the hour, and everybody wants to talk to me, and everybody wants to tell me their story, and I'm kind of just going, phew. This is a heavy position because, to your point, I've got to look votes down the road knowing that my vote in literally a 25% chance of each one of these is going to be heavy as to who goes home tonight. And I wouldn't give this necklace up for anything, but it is certainly a different way to view the game when you do have this on.
Ryan, is it clear that, at least today, that Cody was central in everything because he has the necklace and therefore he knows he's safe?
I noticed the conversation with Cody took a bit longer than the conversations people had with me. Of course, when you're not being talked to as much, you kind of worry a little bit, but you do get your word in with each person. I know me personally, I have 30 pounds of giant clamshells in my bag, so if I get voted out, I get to take those home with me. So, you know, I've been lugging that around just in case I'm walking out with my torch stuff.
How about you, Cassidy?
Yeah, I mean, it's like really tight numbers right now. So if one thing goes wrong, it can blow up a whole plan. Whatever we do tonight is going to have impacts that will probably reverberate throughout the rest of what we see happen in this game.
All right, it is time to vote. Brian, you're up.
I've been left out from Coco from the beginning, so I'm trying to get the power back.